Hello, class. So here we'll take a look at Newton's first law. I'm sure most will intuitively know what happens to our feline friend here if the driver steps on the accelerator. But why? What force causes the cat to move towards us as the car moves away from us? Well, in fact, there isn't a force that pulls the cat toward us, but rather the absence of a force to keep the cat moving along with the car as it accelerates forward. A cat at rest likes to stay at rest, but the dashboard disappears from under it. And that is the essence of Newton's first law of motion, also known as the law of inertia. A body in uniform motion remains in uniform motion, and a body at rest remains at rest unless acted upon by a non-zero net force. Recall what we mean by uniform motion, that is constant velocity, zero or otherwise. The inertia here refers to then the tendency of objects to continue moving with constant velocity or to stay at rest if there's no resultant force acting upon it. Here's a nice example that you can try at home. Place a small coin or object on a card above a cup. Apply a force to quickly kick the card horizontally from under the object. And where does the object land? So you can do this with a flick of your finger and see that it tends to stay in its horizontal position. But without the card, it thus drops into the cup. Some everyday examples of inertia are curling rocks. They're hard to get moving, but once moving, they like to keep moving, particularly if you reduce the friction by sweeping the ice. And a very important example involves us when in or on a moving vehicle. Without our seatbelts, we would continue forward while our vehicles rapidly decelerate or stop, say in an accident, and we'll see more on this in the unit on momentum. One last example that relates nicely back to the earlier examples with the three festive baubles is this demo by retired American physics teacher Bruce Yaney. We have a bowling ball that's suspended by a string and then another string hanging from below it. If we apply a force at the bottom, we're increasing the tension in the top. So we saw with the festive baubles that the tension was the highest at the top because it had to support the weight of all three baubles. Well, here it's supporting the weight of the bowling ball and the force that you're applying to the pencil down below.
Well, my name is Bruce Shaney, and today I'd like to show a classic demonstration of Newton's first law. I have this bowling ball, and it's got a string attached to the top of it, and a second string hanging out the bottom of it. And what I want to do is support it in this metal bar. And as I hang it down, the first thing I notice is that this string is stretched very, very thin. Now my question is, if I were to pull down on this pencil, what do you think would happen? Obviously, one of the strings is going to break, but the question is, which one? So let's see. Okay. Top string broke. And that shouldn't come as a surprise. This ball weighs 6 pounds. It's very heavy. And so it's already applying a lot of force to that top string. I can do this again. And once again, if I pull down on the pencil, the top string breaks. Now I can repeat this all day long, but is there some way that I can actually get that bottom string to break? If I take this pencil and I pull it quickly, the bottom string breaks. Now, in some cases, if I'm quick enough, I can even break two strings down here while it was just one string up here supporting.
As you can see, the heavy bowling ball has a tendency to stay at rest, so the brief force from the string below isn't sufficient to get it moving, and the bottom string snaps instead.